you didn't know offered to just listen to your best-kept secrets, would you take her up on? Well, you might, if you feel you had no one else to confide in. Or Jim Axelrod has been giving her a listen.
This is someone who stole to feed his family to make ends meet.
In her journals, Helena Balla keeps a record of other people's secrets.
This is an army veteran and a double amputee who is coping through his ordeal.
Notes from more than 300 conversations she's had in the past few years.
Rape and abortion story.
Some of it is troubling.
Addiction and prostitution.
Some of it heartbreaking.
Childhood incest at the hands of his uncle.
But all of it is unusual. Because all these conversations Helena's had, people sharing their deepest and darkest, all of them were with total strangers.
It's giving people who don't have a voice, to their family, to anyone else that they know, to their close ones, a voice. Maybe shoot me an email or...
Sometimes the conversations are on the phone.
I don't know what it is about my relationship with my parents.
Often, they're face to face.
I wanted to just tell somebody what a wonderful person my wife was. That she wasn't defined by her drinking. She was defined by this wonderful spirit she had.
Like the two meetings she had with this man. He just wanted to tell someone about his wife, who died from alcoholism.
I really felt I connected with her heart. And she was such an incredible listener.
This incredible listener's journey started 5 years ago in Washington, D.C., where Helena was a lawyer. Heading back from a meeting, carrying her lunch, she saw a homeless man. Something inspired her to sit down, share her sandwich, and start listening.
Here we are sitting on a street corner talking to each other and having a conversation much deeper and much more involved than any that I've really had with close friends and family in the past. So I was thinking, how do I recreate that feeling for other people?
What you do if you're Helena Balla is place an ad on Craigslist, inviting anyone who needed to talk to get in touch. Her Craigslist confessional was an instant hit. How quickly do you hear from someone?
Woke up the next morning, inboxes flooded. First one was a woman who had been a heroin addict for 20 years, and she wanted to share her experience. We were walking through downtown D.C. right by where I worked, and she said that I used to buy dope right here in these corners. She said, thank you so much. Thank you so much for listening to me. And this blew my mind. I mean, I hadn't done anything extraordinary. I wasn't providing any amazing insight into her own life. I was just sitting there listening to her kind of tell me about her journey.
All you were doing
was listening.
And listening and listening and listening to hundreds of people desperate to talk.
And so I started gradually setting up more meetings, and I was taking up afternoons and then weekends, and then it got a little bit overwhelming.
But instead of cutting back, Helena went all in. She quit her job, and with her husband's support, gave her time, full time, to strangers.
Did your husband or any close friends or family say, hey, this is great? You found what you love to do. Go get a graduate degree in psychology. Become a therapist.
This is very different from a therapy session. I'm just listening. I'm not trying to get you to get better or, you know, have an end result.
In a sense, if someone is in real pain and they tell their story and there's no follow-up, there's no healing given, then all she's doing is putting a Band-Aid on a toxic emotional wound.
Martin Goldsmith, a leading psychotherapist, admires Helena's huge heart, but not what he sees as a naive approach.
Being listened to sincerely allows a release. One conversation, two conversations, a bunch of different conversations with a bunch of different people does not give you the tools you need to help heal your pain.
Not just to maybe pull the scab off to see that you have a wound, but to actually dress that wound.
You've got to heal it. You can't just let it sit there and fester. It's never going to heal if you leave it open.
But tell that to the man who lost his wife, who, like all of Helena's strangers, will remain anonymous.
It's a one-time deal. Your life has changed. You're thankful. You're grateful.
The act of her listening to you allowed you to move forward.
Yes, but part of that being her is I'm being self-honest enough to hear myself, to discover myself, to reveal myself to myself. I know that sounds crazy, but that's what it is.
Helena Balla still talks with a few strangers every month and plans to continue as long as there are people who meet her. It's a much-needed reminder about the world we inhabit, even though in this Facebook age, we are sharing more than ever. Plenty of us are still failing to connect.
We live in this age of social media saturation. Aren't we already sharing too much?
Of the wrong thing. I mean, our veneers are quite perfect. We look great, we look like we're functional human beings, no problems, and that's kind of what we want to portray to society, right? We're doing great.
Only everyone's got holes
something
in their heart.
Right.
Helena's prescription to heal those holes is a simple act of kindness. Just listen.
There's a popular saying, a burden shared is a burden halved. So,
that's what you're doing? Having burdens?
Well, yeah, hopefully.